Isa siyang matapang na babae.
When she wants something, hindi niya tatantanan yan hanggang makuha niya kung ano man yung resultang gusto niya.
Kakaiba siya sa buong pamilya niya.
She belonged to a wealthy family. She had a very comfortable life and she gave all of that up.
Pwede naman siyang matulog lang sa bahay eh. Pwede siyang magbili ng pera. Ba't ba parang gustong-gusto niyang tumulong sa mga communities?
Maraming mga usap-usapan, maraming mga feedback. Tinanong din naman ako eh, what do you know about Gina Lopez? Everybody knows the story of Bantay Bata, kung paano niya sinave si Jesse Boy, the boy in the shoebox.
Gusto niyang mag-develop ng children's shows with Philippine content.
Nung kalbo-kalbo na yung lamesa, naisip niyang i-reforest yun.
1, 2, 3!
Yeah! Ito yung taong magtatanggol at magpapakamatay para sa environment.
Kailangan ng mga tao ng tulong, sasabihin niya, bukas kaya puntahan na natin yan.
Everything she created, all the roads she took were the difficult ones.
Gina Lopez is more than Bantay Bata. Gina Lopez is more than Bantay Kalikasan. Gina Lopez is more than I Love. Why? Because it's all about selfless love. GL stands for genuine love.
Tatay ko si Eugenio Lopez Jr., nanay ko si Conchita Lao Lopez. Ngayon, Conchita Taylor na siya. Ito kami magkakapatid, si Gabby, si Gina, Marisa, Rafi, Roberta, ako, tapos yung kasunod ko si Monmon. Yung tatay kasi namin, napaka-impluensyang tao sa buhay namin kasi marami siyang pinagdaanan sa buhay. Nakulong siya ng 5 taon, tapos nakarami siya ng buhay na nasa state siya nung pagkatapos niya tumakas. Kahit na nasa States na kami, gusto niya umuwi. Gusto niya magsilbi sa bansa natin.
It gave me a better grip on what values I should have. Made me think about life and my relationship with society and people.
Yung puso ng daddy ko, kitang-kita namin kay Gina.
She had difficulty with her eyes, so they would put a patch on one eye. And my family thought that maybe something was wrong with her. But it all belies the person she has become.
The 4 eldest siblings, I think, were closer because after me, I think my parents got tired. They took a break for 5 years, and then they had the 3 other siblings.
Growing up, Gina and I were very close. She was a year and a half older than me. And we shared a room for 18 years. I always looked up to her kasi she was really brilliant. And then she was out of the box.
When you have puppies, there's always one puppy that's a little different from everyone. Well, Gina's always been that puppy.
She was always a very idealistic person, even when she was small. When people had problems, they would go to her. And she would teach them that when you're mad, just stand by your bed and pump your fist on the bed. That's how you get rid of your frustration.
Everyone in the family has a soft spot for Gina. She's so natural, and it's very playful and loving.
Her heart always seemed to be towards helping other people, whereas the rest of us were still young, we're more selfish, we're teenagers growing up. But I noticed from Gina early on that she had a purpose in this life that was beyond just being Gina.
When everybody learned how to drive cars, Gina never paid attention to the stoplights. She sees where she wants to go and she puts her foot on the gas and there she goes. I guess that is probably indicative of the way she's led her life.
We were all studying abroad. Gabby was in Maine, Gina was in Boston, and I was in Massachusetts. And sometimes we would get together. I don't know what happened. After that,
she came across this organization called Ananda Marga. She started leaving school and started going into this organization and started learning how to meditate.
And then she came home to the Philippines. She didn't want to study. She said it's useless. Christianity had failed and communism had failed. Ananda Marga was going to save the world.
I was very surprised to learn that when she joined, that part of the requirement was that she cut all ties with her family.
I couldn't keep her in the house because she would run away. We decided to let her do what she wanted, hoping that, you know, she would get over it.
My dad was very hurt. He lost his eldest daughter, and he had no way to talk to her, and she would not talk to us.
Henny was always very hopeful that he said one day she'll just come through the door and come back to us.
This was pre-martial law, so we were still living a life.
She belonged to a wealthy family. She had a very comfortable life, and she gave all of that up.
Lived in Africa among the most destitute, serving Ananda Marga by serving a community of homeless children.
I went to Africa as head of Ananda Marga Mission in Africa. And at the same time, Gina was also posted in Africa. That actually brought us together. We are missionaries. Ananda Marga is a socio-spiritual organization. The philosophy is self-development and service to humanity. Gina was always humble and down to earth. We did not know any background. So she was just one of us. She worked with us every day, just being a simple person.
She followed her path, and it was a very difficult journey.
For the first 15 years, we never saw her.
Hindi namin alam kung buhay o patay siya.
Africa is very difficult situation. That time, when you work, there's a war, famine, a lack of food. But her spirit was great because she always believed in service to humanity.
One day she called. She was asking for money because there was a drought in Africa. And I said, give her money, anything, so that she will be in touch with us. Anyway, it's for a good cause.
Ananda Marga would not allow us to communicate with her. It was about 15 years into that path before my father was able to finally touch base with her.
And the reason we were able to do that was because her boss was someone who became her husband. He was very supportive. He said, no reason why you cannot see your family.
They allowed us to visit her. It was my mom, my dad, Ernie, my brother, the four of us. So we went to Nairobi.
Masaya-masaya kami. Nakasama namin siya kasi nakikita namin sa kanya gutom at uhaw na uhaw siya sa pamilya.
She immediately invited us to her house to have lunch. Her house was like, it was a multicolored house, orange, blue, greens, all sorts of colors.
Wala siyang unan, wala siyang kama, wala siyang banig, wala kahit na ano, basta natutulog siya sa semento.
But she wasn't ashamed. She worked hard there and she was trying to put up schools for Ananda Marga.
I think that time we have more than 50 schools in Kenya and other parts of the Africa also. She started those activities for the poor people.
Nung paalis na kami, lahat kami hirap na hirap kasi iiwanan na namin siya.
When we were in the airport, she and Henny were crying.
Napakatagal hindi namin siya nakasama.
It was so sad for her and yet she stuck it out.
That right there is a window into the kind of person Gina is. If she sees something that she believes in, she will commit herself wholeheartedly. Even if she also had to sacrifice her relationships with all of our family.
And that's because of service. So that for me was when I first realized, my gosh, to give up everything and not even to be supported.
Because they made fun of her, they said, you don't know how to cook, you don't know anything, your mom's calling you. She wasn't happy, but she stayed. And the only reason she finally left was she fell in love with her boss, and the two of them left.
She was just getting used to being somewhere that wasn't Africa. So it was wild. Just watching her, she was fascinated by TV. And you'd go into her room, she would just be there surrounded with all this junk. Yeah, it was like watching her grow up.
When she came back here, she continued. There are lots of poor people in the Philippines, and they need me. So I have a responsibility for my country. So this is my time to give it to my people. That's why she believed the philosophy of her father, service to the Filipinos.
Whatever we do, and wherever we go, we shall always be faithful to our commitment of being in the service of the Filipino. For the Filipino is our only reason for existence.
Si Gina talaga yung reflection ng puso ng tatay ko. Nakikita mo naman sa lahat ng ginagawa ni Gina, yung mga bantay bata, bantay kalikasan.
They're dreamers. They think of things way ahead of time before anyone even thinks of it. When she was with Ananda Marga in Africa, it was that period in her life that taught her to do anything no matter what, be resourceful, find a way, and go to whomever or do whatever to achieve what you need to do. That's, I think, the same kind of ugali she brought to the foundation.
The first thing she wanted to do when she came home was, she said, I want to put a TV set in every school. And we were quite shocked.
Nagkakilala kami nung siya ay kababalik lamang mula sa Africa. Gusto niyang mag-develop ng children's shows with Philippine content.
How can you do that, Gina? You know?
Hindi nakikinig eh. Ginaganyan ko na yung mukha niya. Like, listen to me.
But she set her mind to it and she started down that path.
She will not take no for an answer.
And now, what? We have 20,000 schools with TV sets.
Kumuha siya ng mga tiga DepEd na i-review yung content. At doon na buo, believe it or not, lahat ng manaalala niyo nung bata ka. It was well thought of and was academically researched on what the children watch. We had to study the child eh. Ganun si Gina eh. Kailangan maintindihan kung paano siya gagalaw.
Talagang napaka-tibay nung paniniwala niya. Everything starts with love. With the love for the child.
I saw a news item on television. A little girl was beat up continuously by her mother for a period of 2 years, and at the end of the 2 years, she died. And I thought at that time that if there was a number that girl could have called or the neighbors could have called, then maybe we could have prevented the death from happening.
I remember I was watching TV Patrol then, and then there was a story of this child, this boy. His name is Jesse. Parang limang taon yata siyang itinira ng kanyang lola sa isang kahon. And he couldn't even stand up, no? Parang nakagapang kasi nga nakakadena yung mga paa. And Gina was there to save the child. And ito ang naglunsad nung bantay bata.
Ang talagang gustong mangyari ni Gina ay magkaroon ng isang numero na takbuhan ng mga batang nangangailangan. Tumawag sila sa isang linya at yun yung 163.
Kung nakikita niya, inaapi ang tao, ipaglalaban niya yan. Nagsimula yan sa bantay bata dahil nakita niya, naaawa siya sa mga batang inaapi. Kaya binuhos niya talaga ang oras niya at buhay niya doon.
You had to set up a whole infrastructure. Telepono, yung i-record yung telephone call mo, napiprevent namin yung pang-aabuso.
Meron tayong bantay bata sa Visayas, meron tayong bantay bata sa Mindanao, meron tayong mga bantay bata chapters in other parts of the Philippines.
Because of the persistence of Gina and the resources na ibinigay ng komunidad, doon lang nila narinig yung mga totoong kwento ng pang-aabuso.
Talaga namang nagbibigay ito ng pag-asa. Because, you know, bata ka, ang haba pa ng tatakbuhin ng buhay mo. Kailangan nating mabigyan talaga sila ng pagkakataon na masilayan yung pag-asa that there could be a better life for them.
Doon rin nakadevelop ang judiciary ng mga tamang pamamaraan na hindi pa ikikita yung mukha ng bata. Nagkaroon ng protocol on how to do the story of a child using the medium.
Pag pumunta siya sa Children's Village, hindi lang yung kami ang kakausapin. Nakikihalubilo pa siya doon sa mga bata.
Mabuhay means long live. Okay? Mabuhay ang Playboy!
Mabuhay!
Doon sa home, iba-ibang klaseng bata ang pumunta doon. Wala siyang halong pandidire. Nakikipag-usap talaga siya dun sa mga bata.
Nag-start po ako sa Bantay Bata, 1997. So nakita ko pong nag-evolve yung Bantay Bata from a hotline.
Hanggang sa pag-rescue, hanggang sa residential facility para doon muna sila tulungan.
Tulong medikal para sa pagpapagamot, tulong pinansyal para sa pag-aaral.
Doon po sa programa ng Bantay Edukasyon, nabigyan ako ng oportunidad na
mapagpatuloy yung pag-aaral ko.
Yung desisyon niya hanggang ngayon po umeepekto, hanggang ngayon po nangyayari yung magandang bunga.
Bantay Bata is one of the most amazing things that Gina has done, and I think that's the thing that really launched her and the ABS Foundation into the consciousness of everybody.
The foundation's DNA is very clearly a reflection on what Gina has done.
There's this drive in her to share what she has and to do things for other people. With her, when she started talking about the environment, it wasn't even an issue then. I mean, even at one time, because she was going up on all the buses because of Bantay Usok, there was Bantay Baterian.
It comes out in many different manifestations, but it's primarily based on service, yeah, public service.
This could be eaten. This top of the tree can be eaten.
Which one?
This one.
Let's see.
And there's another.
And this one now is edible.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you see this? This is an ordinary rock. See? Look. You see it? Okay. You see this?
Yun lang.
It's really heavy. Look at this. Oh, see? This is iron. It's really heavy. It's good for the island. Good for the island. Don't take this out.
Kasi yung pagmamahal niya talaga sa kalikasan, nanggagaling talaga kasi yun sa talagang malalim at malakas na pagmamahal niya sa Pilipinas. Yung sinasabi niya that, you know, the Filipinos don't deserve to be poor. And the Philippines is such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful and gifted place.
Baboy.
Yun po, yun.
Sino mo yung pawis ko?
Have you seen a crawling cloud?
Amazing. Okay.
We shouldn't have poverty in this country. We just shouldn't. Traveling the country and seeing the resources that are there and feeling the beauty of our people. I mean, how can we ever possibly be poor?
Oh, anda.
Ito yung taong magtatanggol at magpapakamatay para sa environment. At ang environment sa kanya, hindi lang yung bundok at ilog, hindi lang yung mga dagat, kundi yung mga tao pang nakatira dito.
There is nothing in the world that can stand in a face of a people united for a noble cause. So why don't we work together and then at the turn of the century, turn something really good for 12 million people?
Ito yung kauli-huli ang watershed sa loob ng Metro Manila. Yung shortage ng tubig. Noon pa man din, nakikita na niya yan na kailangan ma-rehabilitate yung totally disturbed na lamis sa watershed para sa kinabukasan, sa mga bata o sa mga anak natin at sa mga apo-apo natin.
So thank you all for coming. La Mesa shows us what can happen in this country kung lahat tayo magsama-sama, magtulung-tulungan.
She's delivered her brand of public service across the country.
Lahat ng suporta na maaari naming maibigay sa kanya at sa ABS-CBN Foundation para mapalawak ang pagtulong sa ating mga kapwa Pilipino ay binibigay natin. Lalo na sa mga panahon ng kalamidad, no? Yung kailangan ng mga tao ng immediate na tulong.
Clearly, we have been partners with her across all of this because she's had to enlist the support of various local officials, various NGOs, and a lot of that is tied into the fact that, you know, they're going to get their particular brand of service onto the public airwaves. She has put all the pieces together and managed to cook something new.
I have had the opportunity to work for the father, Henny Lopez, the son, Gabby Lopez, and Gina Lopez. The Holy Spirit, the person who can move and make anything happen.
When she thinks of something and she believes it, no matter what anybody says, hindi siya makikinig.
One time, She decided to prove that she can bring people together.
She wanted to make a statement. Sabi niya,
there's no one entity that can do this alone. National government, local government, the business sector, the academe, the children, the parents, everyone has to work together. And if we work together sincerely from our hearts, there is no way that this won't happen. So I'm calling everyone to help, to give money, to give volunteer services, to show what the Filipino can do if they do it together. Makakapit bisik tayo para sa Ilong Pasig.
Para kay GL, ang Kailugan daw ay parang daluyan ng dugo ng tao. So kailangan magsimula sa maliliit na daluyan or tinatawag na estero.
I'm Gina Lopez, reporting for ABS-CBN, and I'm here at the San Juan River, and I am totally shocked.
She wanted to show it to the president. Of course, Malacanang PSG said, you cannot do that, it's not allowed, you know her protocol. So in true Gina fashion, she follows the president and gets into the presidential car to point, this is what's the problem. All of us, including PSG, are running after the car because it's just right across. And of course, she says in the two GMA fans, okay, Gina, you fix it, no? You know, it's typical GMA. And Gina did it.
Siya mismo nagbabahay-bahay.
We would walk the length of the estero. We would be picking up basura.
Nagde-dredge kami, naglilinis kami.
Nagma-magic cellphone siya, tawag siya ng tawag. And we were getting everything, DPWH. And all these machines just arrived there.
Marunong kasi siyang makipag-usap sa mga tao.
She was talking to all the people that were affected by the relocation, offering them home.
Ma'am, kailan po yun? Yun po ang tanong ko sa kanya. Soon, sabi ni Ma'am Gina.
Kumbaga sinigurado namin, alam nila at maayos yung lilipatan nila.
At the same time, we were tearing down the houses.
Imbes na magalit sila noon, parang mas minahal nila si Ma'am Gina.
Oh my God. Steve is a boy.
Opo.
Premature, 8 months lang yan, Mom. Oh my God. Oh, gumawa ka na lang nag-isa sa kakilala nito. Marge, may baby na ako. Bye-bye.
Kaya niyang kumain kasama nila.
Yung mga kananayan doon, kinausap niya, binigyan niya ng pagkakataon maghanap buhay.
Yung grades na hindi niyo kailangan. We can make it into furniture.
Bibigyan ko kayo maraming trabaho. Every year, bibili ako. Para ipamigay sa mga kaibigan ko.
Kaya sabi ko, Ma'am, willing po ako mag-train na bilang River Warriors.
Nag-create ng River Warriors kasi alam natin, kahit lilinisin ang ilog, kahit lilinisin ang estero, kung walang magbabantay dyan, nagaling dyan, eh, walang mangyayari sa buhay. Madudumihan naman yan, yung basura, babalik. Yeah. So, kailangan may mga sundalo para sa ilog, sundalo para sa kalikasan. Yan ang River Warriors.
Gina pulled all the stops. Okay, she looked for the resources. We put together people. And she said, let's make a statement. And that's why the run for the Pasig River happened.
Register now for the largest eco foot race in the world.
Let's support a run for the Pasig River.
Let's support a run for the Pasig River. 10-10-10.
In the period of time that we did it, water started to flow. And we were just sitting there and saying, wow!
Dahil nga itinuro namin sa kanila na dapat magkaroon ng relokasyon ng linear park development doon muna sa daluyan, yun na yung mismong template na ginagawa nila sa lahat ng rehabilitation nila para sa muling pagbuhay ng Ilog Pasig. Yun yung binigay namin na legacy kay PRRC na kaya siya nanalo sa Asia River Prize Award.
for an admirable act of being one for the river, the Guinness World Records recognizes the Philippines for breaking the record on the most number of participants in a racing event at the 10-10-10 Run for Pasig River. More than 100,000 people took part to show concern for the Pasig River. Coming from three starting points, everyone converged with burning desire to bring the river back to life. Our most sincere appreciation goes to all who participated, and together, we proved that with a good cause, nothing is impossible.
Ang naging proyekto namin ay hindi magtatagumpay kung hindi nagsama-sama yung mga iba't ibang ahensya sa pamumuno na rin at dedikasyon ni Miss Gina.
So what was Gina? Gina is somebody who can move mountains.
Maraming mga usap-usapan, maraming mga feedback. Tinanong din naman ako, what do you know about Gina Lopez?